We're continuing our shurim on Otzrot Chaim. We are going to again do a bit of chazal this time. We're supposed to start Shaar Anach, but we're going to start again the pereck in Shaar Rafach because I feel it's very, very important to understand. This is a very huge sugya in Etz Chaim that repeats itself over and again. And a person really can get very confused between what is he speaking about. Is he speaking about the Rafach Nitzutzim, or is he speaking about Shach, and then he mentions Par and Shacha. What are all these concepts? We tried explaining it, we did explain it last time, and we're going to go over it due to its importance. Hopefully we'll get things even clearer. We drew a chart as well in order to try to bring out the point, which I'm going to get. Okay. So let's start. So again, we're perik hey avshar rafach netzutzim daf chav tes amud beis in the old edition, and in the matur bidva edition is taf chav hey or taf chav vav. Okay, so I think maybe just give you a general overview of exactly where we're headed. And maybe that will make it simpler for us. Okay, so let me just show you this chart. I'm going to zoom in over here. So we're going to look at this chart over here. And we're going to find there's four principal types of Rafach, Nitzut, well, I shouldn't call them Rafach, Nitzutzim, and Dinim. They're synonymous, one for the other. Now, so here they go. We're going to start with the Rafach. Now, what is the definition of Rafach? We know that's 288. Now, what is the 288? They're called Rafach Nitzutzi Oiras. That's very important, the kud over there, Oiras. Meaning, when the Zayin Malachim broke, they went from the world of Atzilus into the world of Bria. Now, included with the Shivra Kelim fell all in order to Mekayim the Kelim. Okay, straightforward. That's Rafach. Number two is called Shach, which is the Gematria of 320, Nitzutze Kelim. Nitzutze Kelim now. Now, the difference between Nitzutze Kelim and Nitzutze Oras, I will explain to you now. When this Shach also fell down, not to be confused with the Rafach, they also went down. The Loshon here is a little bit to say that it fell down, but more meduic, I think, would be to say it went down. Because the Shvir did not happen, the Shvir happened in the Kelim. Therefore, again, the Kelim broke. The Rafach went down to Mechai the Kelim. The Shach also went down to Mechai the Kelim. Ma Nafkamina. Nafkamina is which part of the Keli is the Nitzutz is going to Mechai. When we're speaking about the Rafach, that's going to Mechai the Pnimius of the Keli. That's going to go in the Keli. Masha Enken, we're dealing about the Shach. The Shach Dinim it's called, or Shach Nitzutz to 320. That's Mechai the Etzem Keli. You understand what I'm saying? The Etzem Keli, not the Emtsar Keli, the Etzem Keli, the actual Keli.
It's not on the sheet, but yeah.
It's called Nitzutzi Kelim.
Yeah, Nitzutzi Kelim. The Chiddush could.
It's clear. I mean, I wrote Nitzutzi Oiras.
I know, but you could have written in brackets.
I didn't write everything down. Yeah. I'm asking. I'm explaining it. It's even better. Okay, so that is what it's all about. That one is sort of the neshama, and one sort of the keli type of thing, in oil, right? Different levels. One is going to go inside the keli in order to mechai the keli, and the other one's going to go into the fabric of the keli, the etzem keli, to mamish mechai the keli.
So that the rapak is sort of like the neshama for
the neshama nitzutze oil. Which are going to go into the keli, into the shivrei keli, and also we're going to have another set of shach, another nitzutz going down in order to mechayim the actual keli.
And that's what we speak about, like doimim having a nitzutz, which is mechayim it. That's talking about the shach. In common speech, we say that everything's got a nefesh ruach and a shama. Yeah,
it's not the same concept.
But it's something which make it exist, I'm saying.
Yeah, it's like in the Shema, that type of idea. Now, in order, that is the Shvira. And every Shvira, there will be a Tikkun, as we know. Now, the Tikkun and the Rafach will be, I call it the Tikkun Ma'at, that's the Loshon I saw, is to the Lamed Beis Elokim, we find in Parshas Bereshis. So it's mentioned Elokim, Elokim, Elokim. 32 Elokims. 32 plus the 288 will make Shach. That's a mituk adir. A ktsatz mituk adir. Okay, let's go back to it. Now, again, we're not going to depth into every single one of them. We're just browsing to understand the difference between them, which is also a big mile.
So what's mematik what?
The as soon as anything falls into a different world, from Atzilus Lamoshel, into Bia, Bria Tiasia, it falls in a mokum which is called mokum Misa. And therefore, mokum Dinim, mokum with all the Chitzonim are there. In order for them to be brought back into Atzilus, they need called a Mitukad Dinim. And this Mitukad Dinim will happen out of the Lamed Beis Elokims.
So the Elohim is actually being Mamtik.
Mamtik, yeah.
Because Hashem Hashem.
Yeah.
Even though it's Mitzvah itself, but it's Min B'minu sort of thing.
We see this over and over again, that even though it's Elohim, Shachim, and this and that, Gvuros, will do the Mitzvah.
So what's the connection between the Rapach and the Shach? In the Lam Beis Elohim?
No.
What's the relationship between...
No relationship. The only the Elohim will be Matik, the Rafach, but not the Shach.
Right, the so why does it end
Shach
up...
Shach will be done in a different way.
So why does it end up as Shach 320? Because you said 32 plus 280 is
320.
It's
Shach,
Yeah. I mean, the Shach's created from...
Okay, there are many different types of Shach. Maybe I should add that as well.
Okay.
There are different Mine Shachs as well.
Right,
so they're not related. No,
right.
You see, the next one is Shach, which is not related to that particular.
This is extremely misleading, basically.
Yeah.
The 288 plus 32 is
Shach. That's Emes.
Shach.
You should know. I'm adding in that it's not similar to the Shach.
It's more of the first one's more of a positive Shach. Is so right.
Yeah.
Shach is which
have
the tikkun.
Yeah. Yeah. That's why I'm stelling on this parag, because it is very confusing. It is very confusing. We'll see this in Etzheim everywhere. Shach, he throws all the concepts without explaining them.
Mm-hmm. Is this the lap non base to do with the non base to see Hochel?
Non base what?
I'd have to get back to you on that. I think I get it. Okay, now let's go to the next Shach. The Shach there, how is it made up, the Shach? So the Rav tells us that you take the Pirush, you take. We know that every Sphilo. With the Zayin Melochim, let's start with the Zayin Melochim is what? Zayin Melochim or Za. Zayin Melochim or Chesed, Gvuah, Tiferet, Netzar, Hod, Yisod. That is the Taich in Za. Za is Vav Ketzovos. Every Sphira we know as the Shem Hashem Keneged Ma. Every Sphira, Za is Keneged Ma. Ab is Keneged Ab, Ima is Keneged Sag. Ab, Azaz Keneged Ma. Not only is Zaz Keneged Ma, every Sphira in Zaz Keneged Ma. So therefore, seven times, the seven Sphiras of Zaz and Nuk, times 45 will get you 315.
How do you get the 315 again?
It's written over here. Where is it written? Zaz Malachin times 45 is 315.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, you add, Zah comes from where? Is Noilet from Ima. Okay, we'll see this concept five. The five Gvuras come from Ima. This five concept of five coming from Ima, as we'll see it over again. So that comes out that the Zayin Melochim come out with the five Shoshim, which it receives from Ima. 315 plus 5 is 320. That's where you get this concept of Shach Nitzutzos that go down into Bia in order to Mechai the Kelim. Okay? As well, the Rav tells us what another Pshat in Shach. If you take the Gematria of Din, which is 64, times it by 5, already that magic name 5, 5 Gvuras, 5 times Din. It's 5 times 65 is Shach Din. Now, the tikkun of the Shach would be as follows.
So this Shach Din, which you just worked out, is that the same as the shach nitzotzos.
That's it. That's all part of number two.
So are they shach dinim or shach nitzotzos?
It's the same thing.
So these nitzotzos are sort of like midas adin type of nitzotzos.
Yeah.
So gevuradik ones.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
Now the tikkun will be when they come up from the world of bia, and they go into the world of atzilus. Where are they going to go? They go up to the ima. That's the. They go back into the ibo stage, and then they're going to get the tikkun. So I wrote over here kishashach nitzotzos olam abriel atzilus leima. Ima is going to massacre them by what? By giving it he the senes ahe gvuros, which is called the tipa. And what are these he gvuros? How are they depicted? How do we see these five gvuros? That's from the eke. Eke is represented by Ima. We're going to take the aleph of that eke, and five times aleph is five, plus the 320 that came up, the shach which came up into Ima, that makes shacha. 325. And that also makes the gematria 5 times adnus is 325. The Rav explains adnus is Aleph Dalit, right?
Nun and Yud.
So Dalit Yud Nun is
Din.
How do you matik the Din? You add the Aleph of Ima. That's why it's called Adnus, called Din Ed Rafia. Rafia, it's a weak din. It's not a full blown din, but rather it has Ima's Aleph in the din, in order to matik the din. So it's din, but Din Ed Rafia.
That's the lower one. Is the Din Ed Rafia?
Yeah. What do you mean lower? As opposed to?
Because Adnus is the lowest of the shameless, isn't it?
Yes, can I get Malchus? Yeah.
As opposed to Din, which is Din Akasha.
Well, the rule is that the lower you go, the more Magashin, the more Dinim there are.
That's what I saw, yeah.
Right. We know that in Bina is Dinim Arimbo. That's the source. We'll see it. Botina de Kanyusa, we'll see it. We'll see about that. Okay, so that's good. So far, we discussed? We decided the Rafach, which is the 288 Netzutzos. We discussed the Shach, which is the 322. We saw the source for that. We saw the Tikkun for that. Now, the third level we're going to see is a Sugya where there's going to be a Tikkun in Nukdiza. Okay, these are Sugyas, Lav Davka, any connection. Okay? Now, how does... We know that the way that Nuk gets a Tikkun is by Zabi Mashpi on her. Okay, now the way is that mashpia. What is mishpia? He's mashpia gvuros. Believe it or not, like we said, this concept gvuros matik gvuros. That's that concept. That ain't din, ain't mituk adim element din. Type of thing like that, right? The Rav says, and therefore he receives some ima chug. Zat receives some ima chasadim and gvuros. He takes the chasadim from himself.
The chasadim he gets from ima as well.
Yeah. Yochchanim Guvri gets because she gets it from Abba. Abba gives it to Ima. Ima gives it to Zah, the Chuk. He's going to take what the Chasadim himself and pass over the Guvos. What is that? Do Tikkun. Mitukadim. Bidin Yerusha, right?
Because it goes through him first.
The Banim always take the Shefa, the Yerusha, and then they pass over to the Banois.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Now, that's only with the Ach Ba'ach. That's only with the Ach Ba'ach. Therefore, Ima cannot pass the Shefa directly to Nuk. But once there's an Asira, when they go Ponim upon him, I'm not explaining all these concepts, but once they separate Nuk from Zah, they separate, Ima then will be able to
directly
into Nuk. Directly into Nuk, Zah goes Bidur Musa, he goes to sleep, and the Shefa can go directly into Nuk. Now that's going to be a Shefa, what's called the 5 mantzipach. It's also dinim. And that's going to give the final tikkun. Now, let's see that inside. Okay. So number 3. What do we see in number 3? We see over here a tikkun of za, a tikkun of nuk. So we see za giving over to nuk. What does he give over? Let's read over here. Hey Gevuos, which is equal he times five, that means five dinim, which is 64, which is shach. He gives over five gevuras, which are connected to five dinim. Din is 64, that's shach. He gives over to her shach. What's the gematria of shach? Na'ar. Na'ar, right? There's a kri ksiv in the posuk, na'ar besula.
Na'ar besula.
We read it, it's a kri. But the ksiv is na'ar besula. What's pshat? What's pshat? Oh, we're going to speak about that. What's pshat in the kri ksiv, right? So the Rambam says that you're supposed to read it. It's called na'ar. So, very good. Now let's go by it. After the nesira, then Ima will be able now to give very comfortably into Nok. What's she going to give? Hey Gevuz, Mantzapach, that's the Hey of the Aleph, the Eker, five times five. Five times Aleph is five. So you're going to add five to what she already has. She has Shach already, 220. That's 325. That gives her a Nara. So once she finally gets this Shefa, the complete Shefa, from Za and Nok altogether, she's completely Metuken. And then you can call her Nara with a hey.
We already said this. You're just adding on the fact that it's Nara.
Yeah.
It's exactly the same as the other
one. Yeah, but it's a different sugya. Yeah. Before we're talking about the Tzutzis falling into Bia and raising them up and going back into Ima, then we're talking about Tikkun of Nok and Zivuk of Nok. That's something completely different.
And it just
happens the same. The Shach, the common denominator. And what is that? So the Piyush. Gevuros.
When we speak about the Aleph of Ema, we talk about the Aleph of Ek, yeah.
Yeah. Pirush Gevuros, Yosem Mutokus Michel Zal, it's all Binyan Ponin the Nok, Liot Roil Zivog Im Zal. Because once you build her up, you're building her Ponim, and that will make her Roy to make a Zivog with Zal. And that's our next sugya, you're looking at number four, Zivog Zal Benok. Zivog Zal Benok. Zah will give into Nok, right? When the time comes when Nok is completely built up, or Acharayim or Ponim, she'll be able to go face to face with Zah and make a Zivog. He will then give a Bashan Zivog, Mantzapach, what's the Gematria of Mantzapach? 280. Yeah. That's Par Dinim. Piyush, that's as the Zohar says, it's Rucha Deshad De Begave, Letakin Yisoida. That's how to do with the sod of Yibum, that's the first bia. Let's give her enough koach to be yoledes all the other children. Bekitzur, so therefore, what would come out? We come out with four different types of nitzutzot or dinim called Rafach, Shach, Shacha, and Pal dinim. So, Shem, when we see this concept in this parak, we'll be able to understand what it's all about. So let's start the Rav. Perek Hey Veda. Says Arizal, Ki bechinas elu rafach nitzut niskor le'el kulam hem bechinas gvuz dinim gmurim. We know they're all mamish dinim because we know what broke malchus the ben. Zu keneged zu. Therefore, the nitzutus which mechay the malchus the ben will be also in that madriga ben, which is the lowest of all madrigas. The shefa is also dinim. Now we're going to bring a few zohars in order to back this up. V'aleim ramuzu rimzu zohar b'mekomis harbe b'mekomis rabe keniske b'parshat pikud deydaf reish nun dalet amud beis v'tachazi. Come and see, says the zohar. Reish dem nuta, which is the top of the parzu, the head of the parzu, gav machshava, inside the machshava, which is the chokma, machshava is the chokma, batash. Batash botzina de kalnusa. Literally translates botzina is ner. De kalnusa is chazak, the very strong ner. That's the makor dinim, which comes from the gvur de atik, is mashpia into arich bina. The gvur de atik is mashpia into the bina of archampin, and that's called the botzina de kalnusa. That's the source of all dinim. The salik begav machshava, and it comes out from that machshava, from that mokum where the chokhmah and bina, there's a zivug between chokhmah and bina, batash is loshon zivug, comes out from there, salik magava nitzutzim. Now these nitzutzim zorik tlat mea ve'eschim ivar, they go flying out 320 different stodim. So we see this musik of shach dinim over here. The bir of psoilis megal machshov, and the rest go into what goes into making the chitzonim. Another zohar, bezriya, parshas betazriya, sorry, daf mem chesamot beis, tna, we've learned. Min botini de karninus nafik shacha, see that? Another musik, shacha, nitzutzim. Misitra de gvura, again from the gvura de atik. The ikon gvura, that's where the source comes from. Another zohar, idra rabba, daf kuflamet beis on the beis. Mistakil havin chiskiel, said, I see with my inner eye. What do I see? Oro nehora yakir de botina yilayin. I see these flying lights all over the place. They're from the botina. Nehir v'salik l'shacha 325 iva. Again, this musa of 325. V'afo b'shesham nire shem shach nitzutzim. V'kan anu korim oisem rafach nitzutzim. What's going on here? We start with a pereck called Rafach, 280. We go to an inning called Shach, 320. We see in the Zohar, it's 325. Says the Rav, a kol inin icha. The Yidbar b'zat Hashem ata lemat. And I explained last time, we learned this, that the Mepharshim ishtiklam is bold, because we'll find that at the end of the pereck, it's not explained. Unfortunately, that the one Pirush wants to say that Pshat is missing some kutchosim. Anybody knows a little bit of the history of Kabbalah, of the Tar Niyorim, and the various shtashilus of the ksovim of the Rav Chaim Vital v'chlal, it's a ness that came out from the Geniza, Sazachida, and other places. It's a ness b'chlal, we have the ksovim, and it's no wonder that maybe some of the pages were missing. That's what he ties. On the time of that, he was hiding some of this information. And sometimes that he just didn't get around to explain. So whatever the sibba is, let's just ask a little bit of the confusion over here. Let's continue. V'hine, heyos mimispar shach nitzutzim hem, who? So let's deal first of all with the shach nitzutzim. K'hine, elu nitzutzus hem b'chinet sheva malochim demesu. As we explained, right? The shach is 7 times 45, right? The sign malochim 7. V'hine hem b'chinet zakin noda. V'hu b'zah nikra odom. V'fi sheyesh bo havayas de alofim agmatris odom. Odom, which is Gematria 45, and that is the Havaya de Alofim, which is Ma. The Kol Melech, and Kol Melech, Dahinu, every Svira me'elu her Odom Echad, Nimsa Sheva Pamim Odom Hem Gematria Shintesvav. It's 315, like we explained. Ashakula Ham Nitzutsu Shel Gvoz, Dinim Gmurim Shel Sheva de Molochim Shevesu. And they are adding to the 350 Nitzutsos. Now, when it comes to the Zman of Tikkun, Tikkun happens, meaning Tikkun always is more on the Zivug. That's the ultimate Tikkun. So Abba were giving his 5 tipas into Ima. Ima is mishtatef, her 5 tipas together, they will not make 10 tipas. Not to lead you wrong, what's most important here, we don't focus on the chasadim, we're building up Nok, we're building up the Zayim Malachim, which principally is in a form of dinim. Therefore, we're going to focus on her 5. So her 5 plus 350 will come out to be Shach. Ben kulam hem shach nitzutzim. Ki chamish explains ki chamish chasadim de abba inam nitzutzim rak chasadim. She nitzutzim hem bechilas gvuos belvad. Since we're only reckoning with the nitzutzim, which are gvuos, we only consider her 5 because hers is gvuos. But often she chintas vav nitzutzim hem yishenos shel sheva malachim. Vachamish nitzutzim acherim hem chadoshes. So we're not considering his 5 on her 5, 5 plus 315 is 320. That's your shach. That's going to make the tikkun. Let's continue. The kavaya dat, you should know. Ki gam benukva dezal, shehi shfiyas sheva malachim, yesh ba kolel es kol sheva malachim. You have to know that even in nukva, which is the last of the spheres, also she broke, you have to know she also has 7 times her sphere. Can know that the lay svira the law is kalilis bach bechinas malchus. V'nimtza ki hem shach nitzutzim achirim benukva deza. So you also have this cheshbon of 7 times 5 plus the 5 gvuos of ima, which come out to 320.
So when we speak about the 7 of za, were we not counting malchus as one of them?
Yeah, yeah. And now we're counting znuk, we're going to say 7, there's also 7 there as well.
So the last one is kind of the koilel of all 7 of nuk, basically.
That's malchus is always the koilel, yeah. It's actually koilel, the koilel. Yesod is the koilel, and malchus is the koilel, the koilel. V'noda, ki kol ha'gvus v'dinam hem kfurim. We should know that one of the pirushim, like we said last time, is that it's considered, gvus considered like fire. Fire grabs onto something, you see the way it's mekafel, it's misgaber on itself, it goes higher and higher. That's the Indian over here, kfulim, of gvus. V'nim says, yeshtei pa'amim shach bizans. Therefore, obazor, when we say the shach dinim, you have to understand, double it. Asher lisibosam hu nikra za shemesh. That's the 2 times 320 is 640. Shem b'chines nitzuzes elo. V'shtei pa'amim shach benukva asher lisibosam hu nikra tama. Which again is 640. V'hem b'chines nitzuzes elo shebo. V'kol elo nitzuzes shelo v'shela nis'arun b'mayima v'nis'tayirim v'nis'kayim sham. If there are all of these shach dinim and the shach of zah, shach dinim of avnuk, go into iman and mima boch Hashem. That's where the mokum of ibo is. That's the mokum of tikkun. Laavin in shacha.
And they get the tikkun by going up to iman.
Ima in ima's ma'i ima. That's where the tikkun will happen. She'll give him 5 gvuos there.
The netzutz go up or zanuk themselves go up.
All the shivar kedim and the netzutzim all go up.
What about zanuk themselves?
That's the zan. That's the zan malachim. Zan Malachim, all the Shvir, they died. There's no Azah. There's no Manok. They broke. They died. They went into Bia. Now all these Shivar came are going to all go back up, build themselves back up, wear back in Ima.
And then come out.
Amazing.
And then come out as a complete Zan.
Yeah.
Oh, so they're all broken.
Yeah, they're broken. They died. Any Yitzir from Oilam Lo'im is called Misa.
That's why every day we have to build up a new Zion.
Yeah, exactly. Now, new sugya. We're talking about now Zavinok. Zavinok, we got a Shacha. Ve'ini Rafa. So, we've got Ma Marim and Niskar, and we've got Niskar, the Parshas Bo, the Zon Bo, Parshas Daf Lamed Aleph, and we've got Zilu Shoyna. Ki yiye Nara Besula. State, it's a Kri, right? Nara Besula. Ve'em is. Frekt the Zohar. Nar ksiv. Why are you reading it now? It should be now. My time. And Mishum, the Kolzban, the look, Kabilas, Docha, the Ikaris, now. Kolzban, she hasn't received from the Zohar, and you have to add him from the Ima as well, she is only considered to be the now. Okay, as we showed on the sheet over here, because only when she gets the extra fire from Ima, she's going to be Shacha, which is the gematria of Nara. Pirush Shem Adnus Morel Din Kenoda. We know the Adnus Morel, like we said, the Dalet Nun Yud is Din. Vechen Shlosha Oisus are Achroin Tem Din. Nisha Ois Rishona Shihi Aleph. Vehi Bechinus are Rachamim Ameshutav im Adin Sheba. Ve'ois Aleph Zu Morel Shem Ekesh U Rachamim. Zu Atam Shenikra Malchus Besefer Zohar Din Rafia. לפי שמתחברס עם אויס א' שהיא רח מקניסקה ואז היא דין הרפיה. אז פשעת דין הרפיה, because the א' of the אימא is, it gets together with the דין, that's the דין הרפיה, that's אדנוס. כבר ידעתי ששורש כל הדינים הם בחינס 5 גבוהות. All the שורש is 5 גבוהות. וכל גבוה מהם נקרא דין. Okay? גבוה equates דין, not גמטרי, but in ספורה. Now, Shehem Shlosh Oises, excuse me?
Svar.
Din and Gvor, you find no kesher? Din, Gvor is Din. They're both on the left-hand side. Shehem Shlosh Oises Achroinus Shebeshem Adnus. The Din, Dalet Yud Nun, is the last three letters of Adnus. Vin Tomna, Im Tomona Chamesh Pamim Din, 5 times Din, Yigimat Cheshach, 320. Nimsa ki chamesh gvuos and nikot dinim. Five times the gvuos will equal, it's called dinim. Now, mispashtim ad shach, ad mispach shach nitzutze, nechlolim kulam b'chamisha gvuos elu. So all of that is one inyan. The five dinim, which is 5 times 64, is 320. That represents the five gvuos, which is a dinim, which is mispashtim to 320 nitzutzos. Mm-hmm. That's all included into the five gvuos. Okay, so every time we talk about the hey gvuos, think about it as 320 nitzutzos. Because dinim, which is a gvuo, five dinim is 320. V'zisha omu parashat pikudei kiniska le'el. Batash botine karnusu, was a zibug about to, he's going to learn a different pshat of it that originally he learned. Zarig l'shach iva, it split out 320 nitzutzos. Pirosh, ki botine de karnusu, he saw b'chines shorei shel gvuos dinim aman, and mi'ikoran, we said that's the gvuo, the atik. V'hine hi omenes begav ima, he goes right into toch ima. Very famous lotion of the Zohar, dinim is arimba, they awaken, they become fully mu'orer, the dinim there in ima. V'zish omru be'idol zutra v'hai botin in the kanusa ganiz gav me'amei moi de ima. That's what we understand, the botin in the kanusa was the shores of dinim are found in the mother's stomach, that's what it means.
Are they actually proper dinim there, or just the shorish of dinim?
Well, what's the difference between shorish and proper?
Is actual dinim, is it?
It's actual dinim, that's the shorish. Shorish is the same thing.
V'lchein
botzina zois, he notens kitzba mida, mishcha, lekol svira, keniska, b'mama, kav, mida, kos of ksav yad. The ksav yad, that is the Zohar Chodesh. Zohar Chodesh. Now we can look at dinim as a negative sense, as we said last week, but also we can look at gvul as a very, very positive thing. How can it be positive? Because it gives gvul, it gives the keli what it needs, the strength in order to contain what it needs to contain. Bereish tikun ahei shebe tikunim, or b'mokom etzharbe, v'tam lefi shekol medida kitzva eno elo midat gvura. So again, you need both. Too much chesed, ispashtus is a full potential with no actuality, that doesn't help you. Only gvuos is kula dina, it's only fire, that won't help you. But when you have the combination of both, the constriction of the chesedim in order to actualize your potential, that is the optimal. That is what we're trying to achieve over in Kabbalah. V'hine, kol ha-malochim shemesu, yotzu megav b'hai botin l'karnusa. All the malochim we know came out from the source of botin l'karnusa. That's one of the sibos why it broke, because there was too much dinim. Sigim. וכמו שכתוב בעידר זוטרה, לדב רשתדק בייס, עמוד בייס, נוציצים אפיק זיקים בזיקים לשח איבו. That's פשט. They all split into 320 ניצוצים, because those were all the dinim which were licked inside the זי מלוכים. כי אלו ניצוצים זרי בהי בוצים לקרנוסה, היי מלכי דעל ועל מן קדמי בהתחרבו ומסו. That's the סיבה, because it was such stark dinim in the מלוכים, they all broke and they sent away everything dispersed. Shai bem shach nitzutzim kiniska le'el. V'achakach, ali de oisam chamnaz zetikon. V'achakach, ali de oisam chamisha gvuos kadishim acharin, shem tipa itipas ima kiniska, kiniska be'id rabba, guf mem beis amod alav, kuf lam zan amod beis, v'hem mitbasimu v'nitkinu oisam alochim kadmim shem shach nitzutzim. And he's calling the parshas Naso Daf Kuflamen. Okay. V'az nitzdarfum nitchabu nitbariru v'yotzu mehem apsoiles. V'amiborer shebehem ola lemal besod ibu gav mai ima kinizkel el bedush ima. So you see, he's constantly repeating this gav mai imo, because that's where all the tikkun happened. Because they started off with shach dinim, they go back into her. She's going to give the five, That's going to make a shacha. Shacha. That gives the isbasimu, the mituk adinim that the Zayim Malachim need at this point.
Which part of Uma is this exactly?
In the Yisod.
Yisod.
Yeah. וזה שאומר בפרשת פקודי דף ריש נון דלת עמוד בית, זה בוצין לכאן נוס לזרק נוצוצים לשח עיבה, שהם שבע מלוך נצקורים, ואחר כך בירה פסולת מלגב מחשובה, והוא על ידי אילו חמש גבורס קדישין אחרים. Those are the five גבורס, interesting enough, like we said, keep on repeating, the גבורס, or matic the גבורס, and that's matic the dinning of the 320. והנה, ביצברר אימיים אלו חמישה גבורס קדישה מאחרינין, נאסים כמספר שחה כניסקה פרשת תזריר דף מהם חס עמוד בייס כניסקה לאל. Once those five entered into Zah, now he goes from שח to שחה. תהנה בוצינה דקן נוסן נאפיק שחה ניצוצים. וגם זה שאומר פרשת בלק, בלק דף חשתס עמוד אב, שחה זיגי לסיטרה חד. ואלוהם סוד, פרמוניזיו של גבורס, שהם הספשתי בכל ארבע קצובס, הבינה אימא אלוהי, because the זוב is כנגד בינה. Alright, let's continue. וזה שאומר בעיד רבה, דף קוף למד בייס עמוד בייס, אמר רבי חזקיה, מסתכל הבינה אנא, I used to see with my inner eye, נהיס וסליק שחה איבה. 325 ניצוס were flying all over the place. ובתחילה הבו שח, באמס, there was 320 in the beginning, בלבד. Those were the five גבורס. חמש פעמים דין, the אדנוס, שהם שח ניצוצים, right? The דין, 64 times 5 is 320. וכאשר נצחבו עם מים חמש אלוהים, אלופים, עם חמישה דינים שהם בנכינס חמש שמויס עקב, שהם רחם יויוס מהם, אז נתמטיקו ונתבסמו חמש פעמים דין. ונעשה חמש פעמים אדנוס, ובגמרת שחה ניצוצים. אז הוא explain that אדנוס is made up of two parts, דלת נון יוד, and the אלף. Where's the אלף come from? אלף is the ביסום, the mituk that אמא is giving over to the dinim in order to matic them. And since we know there's five gurus, five dinas, 65, that's 325, which comes out with his musag of dina de rafia for adnus. Vezen nikra malchus dina rafia kiniska lael. Shasham adnus ha'alef shabo rachamim. Veshah oishes din, v'lachen hi din mozug rafia, v'rafia. באופן ששם אדנוס הם נקרא דינה רפיה, ואז הם שחה גבורס, ואיזה שחה הם ממתוקוס, נמצא שאז שח ניצוצים נהירים מאוד, מצד אויס אלף או מצחברס ימיים, וזה שאומרו נהיר. That's why he said נהיר, it's bright, it's shiny, it's מסוכן, וסלק לשחה איבה, ואז שאז הם מאירים ואינו חשוכם. As you see, he keeps on repeating them over and over, and basically, as... I don't really understand all the repetition, but it's a good chazal anyways. Mm-hmm. Now, let's continue. Now we're going to speak about specifically the tikkun of Nok. Obizit tavi mashi kos parashat tazri I inyan nar v'nara. Again, he's repeating himself. Nar gematre shach nitzutzim ad lo nitbasim. Once fine, you get the hey from the ima, five times alf is hey, she becomes a nara. That's the kri. V'nari gematre shacha hi kasha nitbasim al yedei shem ekin. שהוא בהי לא בינו, והמורה על אויס אלה שבשם אדנוס, שנתבסמו על ידי חמש אלפים, שיש בו חמש פעמים דין כניסקר, כנגד ההי ראשונה שהיא, בינה כוללת חמש אלפים. חמש פעמים אור נזכר בתיקון עם תיקון ההי, ואז נקרא נער יתיר ההי, שגש את האקסטר ההי, through the five אלף. ואז היא בוחנת שחת דינים במוסומים, או ממותוקונים, ואז יכול להיות מקובלת עם הזיווג הזוכה, this is the final, the new Nakuda is adding. What's going to happen now? She gets the extra five. The extra five is going to help her build up her ponim. Once she builds up her ponim, she'll be able to go ponim to ponim and make a zivug with that. That's what he said. ואז יכול להיות מקובלת עם הזיווג הזוכה או מזדווג בו. מה שאין כן תחילה, עד לא מתבסמו, she was בחינת only שח, נער, and a nara cannot make a zivug with a nara, right? And therefore, she had become a nara. Ve'omnam inyan elu chamisha yeterim, amim besami, amim metakanim, mitkanim. ממתיקים, השח, ניצוצים, הם הגבוס, אני קורא מחמישה אויסות, מנצפח. הניסקה אצלנו במוקום רבים. So again, when za and nok separate from a situation of ach ba'ach, ima will be able to mashpia directly into nok, and what is it going to be mashpia? The mansabach, the five gvuros, which is going to give it the extra hay. And then she'll be able to go ponim upon him and make a zivug with za. V'hine, mansabach gmatria, this is the last and final four nitzutzos, the fourth nitzutzos that we're speaking about called the par. The par. Which is the gematria of mansabach, by the way. Here, mansabach gematria par. V'chiluk yesh ben shach nitzutzim uben chamish gvuros mansabach hiuze. Huze. She'elu shach nitzutzim hem gvuros anukva atzmo. Vem not no besfir zamachos ba. Well, we find that the shachar is given over from ima into no. Well, she gives the extra five, which makes into shachar. כמובור אצלנו שכל שלוש בחינס הכלים של הספירה הזו הם שלוש השמועס אדמוס. וכבר נצבר לאל, שחה הם חמישה שמועס אדמוס. Means like this, that we know it's like for like. Means that in every keli there's three בחינס. There's a בחינה of the keli, we explained last time this. The keli chitzon, keli emtsoi, and keli pinimi. And if you look in the Shash Shemois and Etz Chaim, you find that all the names of the Kelim are Adnos. Adnos. So therefore, it makes sense that what's coming over here is that all the three Kelim, the Malchus, which is Nukva, the Shem Adnos, that's why the Shacha, the Dinim, are going to come into her, are going to be going into her in order to, because Min, Kimotsu Min Es Mino, because the Shachach Dinim is Mamish, which is the Adnos, finds the Kelim, which is the... That's why these nitzutzos follow all the way into the Nok. Into the Nok. Omnam. Gvuos, that is all about Shacha. Now, what about the Pal? Omnam, Gvuos, what's the difference between them? The Gvuos Matzbach B'chin is Gvuos Azocha Shebo. Right? We got that clear. Shacha is Nogeh to the Nok, and the Pal be Nogeh to him. She'achakach notnim Eleha. So she's going to be receiving shacha from, well, actually only hey, together it's shacha from Ima. And he's going to be mashpi on her par, as we explained at the Gdom of the Shiur. How is by in a shacha nitzusa or par nitzusa nitzran becoming because of the Zohar? Vehine, no, shehem bechinas nitzusa sheh, shahayu besheva malochim kiniska le'el, sheyesh ba'em shlosha bechinas, ha'em kelim, Nitzutzim, oh, so therefore we're basically beside the inner over here again in every sphira, in every patsuv. There's three very important bechinas you have to consider. One is the kelim of the patsuv, one is the nitzutzim of the patsuv, and one is the oilus of the patsuv. So far, divine, all we've been talking about the four different types of nitzutzim of the patsuv. The other two will be left to the next shah, which is called shah anach, which is called. Anach for Oyvus Nitzuzus Kelim. Venitkenu Alide Par Nitzuzin de Mansapach. She's going to be Mesakin. Zah is going to go with the Par over to Nuk. Nuk is Mesakin herself. Shegam hem Bechinus Nitzuzin. Vekulem hem Dinim Vigvuros. Now if it became still is Mesakin her. Ela Sheelu She Mansapach hem Mutukonis Yoise Meod Mishacha Nitzuzin. Again, Ima was mashpia on Nok directly. Shacha. That is a very good mitukadim. Nevertheless, when he's mashpia, when he goes zivuk ponim v'ponim, and he goes zivuk with Nok, he's also mashpia on her at mitukadim, which is on a higher level. That's called paldim.
Is that paldim what he gives her or after the tikkun?
What he gives her, he's giving her mansapach. The gematria of mansapach mem nun. Yeah. All those the letters is 280.
And what happens after he gives it to her?
Alright, it's not a sugi right now, exactly. How it affects her, his feels, and how she changes.
And it's none of these four. It doesn't turn into anything else in terms of nitzotzis.
No, that's it.
You have something much higher.
That's Masakana Yesod, and that's the Ruach, the Shadi Bala, Shadi Gave, as we spoke about. Nothing else comes out. Those are the four basic ones. And it says, Zachor Akdamazu. And remember this, he says, The Shach and Nitzutz were Pal de Matzbach. Mainyan Bekol Mokum. This is a tremendous opportunity to remember this and to go over this, because he doesn't repeat himself. This is one of the few Makos where he goes about Richas in order to explain this.
There's some of them before the Nasira, some are after the Nasira.
Yeah.
So the ones which are.
Like number three, if you go through number three in the chart, you'll see that before the Nasira, then the Ima is giving it to Nog after the Nasira.
So as I said it to it, first is Shach, then Shach, and then it's Parah.
That's right. Exactly.
Right. So Shach is before the Nasira. That's when it's
she becomes a Nar. Right. That's forming her.
And she's getting these Gevuros from where?
From Zah.
Right.
See the arrow? Zah is giving over to Nar. Right.
So, and that's the Shach Dinim.
Yeah, that's the Shach Dinim.
Which is the Sheva Melochim plus an extra five from Imam, which is got given to Zah.
No.
For some reason.
No, it's the five Gevuros.
Five Gevuros.
Five Gevuros, what Zah received from Imam, he received the Gevuros, five Gevuros from him.
Right.
From her, five Gevuros is five Dinim. Five times 64 is 320.
So
that's what he's giving to
her. Right. So he's giving over the five Gevuros to Nook.
To Nook.
And that's no, but then you've got the Nasira, and so Emma can give directly to Nook.
He goes to sleep, the Shefa now goes directly into Emma.
She gives us a different five Gevuros?
She gives a different five Gevuros, correct.
Right, plus the five Aleph.
Five Nan Tzapach.
The five Aleph.
Which is the five Aleph?
The five. Because she's already got 320 from Zah.
Okay, we don't say that. It sounds like we're just fudging, you know.
No,
got 320, I'll just put it on the van.
No, she keeps
she is a now. She's a now. She's 320.
Ah. So because otherwise what was the point of Zah giving to Nook if it's going to be taken away straight after the Nasira?
She is what she is.
She's still and then she's mumtick those 320
with dinim. About five Aleph of the Ekev. Yeah,
five months.
It's called five Matzvah. Five Gevuros, five Matzvah. It's all synonymous. Look. Five Gevuros equals five Matzvah, which is
five Din.
If anything, it's the Aleph is more Rachamim.
No. The five Din she's got is 320.
Correct.
Right. Then after the Nasira, she gets an extra five from the five Alephs.
From the Ekev, Ima.
Which are five Din, five Gevuros of
Ima. Five Gevuros, or we call them five Matzvah. It's also five Mantzabach. It's a type of Mantzabach. Take my word for it.
Right, okay, fine.
Okay.
Okay, right.
And then later on,
then
will build up upon him.
And then she can be
bestowed. She can go upon him, and he's going to give to her
to Mantzabach.
Power.
Power.
Which is Mantzabach. Correct. Excellent. Okay?
Yeah.
Let's finish off. Now, Le'el, says the Arizal, V'ayin le'el daf ches amud beis, which is Shana Kudim, anybody wants to look up, Shana Kudim, Perkei daf ayin ches. And there, in Matuk Vidvash, it says over there, in an alba mina oils, we know there's Tanta, you know, there's Tamim, Nikudois, Tagim, Nitzutzos, right? Now, Nitzutzos, says the Rav over there, create the Kalim.
Why is he getting the tzitzis? Oh, we haven't done that yet in the other shit.
Well, no. Let me repeat. You're correct. There's five types of oilers, he calls them. Mm-hmm. Tanta. Tamim, Nukudus, Tagim, Oisius. Correct. Right. I made a mistake. Oisius. Where did the oisius come from? Nitzutzim. They come from the tzutzim. You have to know the sugi over there. That means that the or choizer over there of the sphere will hit into the Or Shima, that will cause a new Or, which is called the fourth Or, which is called the Or of Nitzutzim. And he declares over there, what is this Nitzutzim all about?
That's not the Rapach itself?
No, this is in Akudim, this is before the sphere.
Ah.
The Akudim before the sphere. And these Nitzutzim, Zokter is to build the Kelim. Zokter Rav over there can't be the Kelim already exists, it must be just to Mechai the Kelim.
Before Shiur.
Before the Shiur, yeah.
So how?
Because we're forming a keli. In order to form the keli, you have to extract the ore in order to megashim the ore. Kelim is also ore. So you have to extract the all, which in the more megashim chelik of the all, that's megashim the all, which creates a keli. But if you extract all the potential all, you destroy the keli. So you have to send over a bit of nitzutim in order to mechayel the keli beni beni till you put the all back in.
Is that what you're talking about when the spheres go back into the pelvis?
That's right. That's right. That's a kulim, right?
And that's the orchoza and some of the stuff.
I don't know if you've seen it yet. Okay.
Well, we did it in our kudim.
Yeah, okay. Good. That's
but
it.
But it's bringing the kudim in. Shine the kudim. So it must be something else to shine the kudim as well.
It's no gate in the kudim. What do you mean?
It says,
Tanta, right? Tam tagim or nitsusim oisios.
Which oh, it doesn't say what Shaar. You said what Shaar.
Shaar akudim, right?
Shaar akudim. Akudim, right? Sorry.
Or misham tavin. Ki ulai oisa he's masupik. The Rav Chaim Vital here will say atzorchin in Rav Chaim. He's asking the following shayla. Ki elu oisa nitzutzos hem dinyon el rafach nitzusim shibekan. Okay, that he's clearing over there. What is the nature b'chalal of those nitzutzim flying out of this batosha, this hitting of the orishima and the or choiza, the hitting, the creating these nitzutzim? What is the teva? So is it taken like we see over here in the Shaar Rafach? She begins as revi. It's revi. What's revi? It means tamim nekudas oisius. Sorry, tamim nekudas tagim, and the fourth begin of the or is oisius. So maybe they nitzus create the kelim. Begin a revi. O efsha.
Can you say that again?
There's the four things that or can create.
Right, which are.
Tamim,
the tanta,
nekudas, tagim, oisius. Oisius is bechina revi. So efshar these nitzutzos, which are created by this batosha, is going to create the oisius, which is bechina revi or efshar. She bechina shnir. It's not bechalal oisius. It's not the last. It's the nekudos. These nitzutzim are creating nekudos. She bechina shnir. Shehem bechinas nekudos. Shebe nikudim hayotim me'ayim. Shem dinim ve'o choyze ve'o achorayim ha'me'irim bekelim. Ache yoysim nishborim. Ve'nis'alu mehem, ve'nis'talku mehem, ve'nis'taku ores anika o yoshe v'tzorchim. Not sure whether it's taka, the Shaila b'tamtzit, the Shem Shmuel explains, is either the bechina of o dinakudim or bechinas kelim dinakudim. That's what he wants to touch this up in. Kids are black tzorchim, but that's not the ik of the pereck. The ik of the pereck is to understand the four dinim, four different types of nitzusat and dinim. Hopefully that's cleared up a few questions. And next week, next time, we'll be going on to the next Shaar. Okay, shkoyach.